Hi everyone. Today I'll be showing you how to create and utilize a class in MATLAB. Classes are essentially coding templates for creating objects, allowing the object to share properties and behavior. As you can see here, I have an outline for an object class that represents a dog. So this class can have properties such as the breed and the age, or methods such as eating and walking. And you can use this class to create an object instance, which re will represent an actual dog, in this case, a dog named Francis, which has the properties that it's a husky, that's 19 years old, and it can also eat and walk like any other of the dogs. First, to create a class in MATLAB, you can simply just go to Home, New, and Class. This will open an untitled, unimplemented class with comments describing each section and an example prop of a property, as well as a constructor and an additional method. For a second time, I've already implemented a class for rectangles here. At the top is the class definition, in this case rect, which stands for rectangle, which wraps the whole file all the way to the bottom. Next, I have the properties field, which is made up of two variables representing the length and width of the rectangle, appropriate name, length and width. Then, directly below this, I have my methods. First, the constructor, which will create an object of this type of rectangle, given a length and width, which are represented by L and W. Then I have getWidth, which returns the width of the rectangle, as well as less than, which tells you if an object is less than another object. GetLength, which returns the length of the rectangle. And setWidth, which sets the width of the rectangle if it is greater than 0, as well as area and perimeter, which return the area and perimeter of the rectangle, respectively. To create an instance of the class, you need to call the class constructor, which by convention is the first method implemented in a class. Like with other MATLAB values, objects can be assigned a variable like so, and we can also access it in the workspace. So if we run this here, we can see that r small is assigned a rectangle with length 1 and width 3, and r big is assigned a rectangle with length 10 and width 20. Both the properties and the methods of a class can be accessed using dot indexing. For example, r small.length will return the length of the object represented by r small, and r big.width will return the width of r big, and r big.area will return the area of the rectangle. As you can see here, you can also use dot indexing within the class, which is how you create your constructor to set your inputs, in this case L and W, to the lengths of the object which is returned. Just like any other MATLAB function, methods are essentially just a group of functions within a class definition. Okay. Next, you might notice something above the properties, which is the accessibility. Methods and properties, by default, are public, meaning that you can directly access them using dot indexes both inside the class definition and outside the class definition. In MATLAB, there's three levels of accessibility. There's public, protected, and private. Here are some of the differences between the three. So for all three methods, you can access the class's variable properties and methods within the class. However, outside the class, only public allows the properties and methods to be accessed. In general, it is good practice to have your properties be private and to have methods which allow the user to access properties without changing them with functions that get and set the values, which is why I have functions such as getWidth, getLength, and setWidth. This way, you can control how the user sets different values, such as limiting the width to be set to only positive numbers. Lastly, one extremely useful functionality in MATLAB is the ability to create arrays of objects and use vectorized code to perform operations on large amounts of objects at the same time by using the square brackets and inputting all the different objects of the same type. And then you can perform vectorized multiplication on the whole array at once, like so. The ability to do this saves lots of time when working with large numbers of objects. This concludes the video on creating a simple object class and some cool things you can do with objects in MATLAB. Check out the links below for more information, and thank you for watching.